the design intent from the early days was described as if Swedish designers for Nike went and developed a product in Japan. Core works through a couple mechanisms primarily. So we've got two dry electrode EKG sensors here. And with that, we're actually able to sense your electrocardiogram through your thumbs. So when you go to meditate with this device, it's actually collecting biofeedback information. And with that information, we're able to understand and analyze your autonomic nervous system and how it changes and reacts when you're going through various mental exercises. What that means from a systems design perspective is that we have a couple high impedance pathways, and that's super important to track and has to be balanced in just the right way. Otherwise, the device includes some LED controllers, power system, battery management, and a Bluetooth and application processor. And all of that's integrated into primarily the upper assembly PCBA. There were several key challenges that we had to face, ranging from like matching the mechanical outline to actually getting all the test points in place to making it manufacturable and reliable. In the design phase, we intentionally chose as low risk and as easy to use and as flexible products as possible in order to make something work and move quickly and be flexible as the startup changes and pivots. Altium really enabled us to do that, pushing and pulling traces, having to actually drive the test points through, whether they were through-hole vias or actual test points that were routed out. And then managing the particular loads on the lines, the parasitics and all that. You go from using some rinky-dink DIY layout tool to actually using Altium, and you can deliver the files. And you work with everyone's systems, everyone's fab house, where they ask you, oh, just drop the files in and we'll get it made. Like, great, cool, quick turn. Get it back. So it really shrinks the actual time to market and shrinks our time to iteration, which is one of the most important things for a startup. After the design phase, as we move to more design for assembly, design for manufacturability, design for test, we were able to easily drop in test points where we hadn't thought about putting them in. We were easily able to export different formats, export lots of different document styles for various manufacturer requirements in order to really move quickly on supplying the kind of documentation that we need to build and scale.
Please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.